It is that time again where we get another little teaser trailer for the Bleach anime. You know how it is. Last time we got the Ichigo in the human world. Now we're going to get the Quincy and the Sturm Ritters for this one. And then the next one will be on the 8th, which I believe will be the Soul Reaper. So I'm excited. This is 30 seconds long. A bit shorter than I would have liked, granted. But yeah, I'm just excited to get into this. If you haven't already, click the like and subscribe if you want to see more content in the future. So let's get onto this bad boy because I'm excited to watch this. 3, 2, 1, go. Bambi? I got told there was Bambi in here as well. Yuha looks great, considering the details in his face. Bambi! Oh my god, yes, Bambi! Okay. Robert, Master Masculine, okay. Brilliant display of gore there. Okay, that was when they first appeared, Asno. Yeah, these looking good. The blue veins? Is that new? That might be new. Ayo, chill! Oh, there's a lot to talk about here, isn't there? Ooh, okay. That was awesome. Oh, I need to rewatch that. I really need to rewatch that. Okay. Robert, Bambietta, Asnat, Basby. Because Yuha has so much detail in his face. So I like these up close shots because you get to see I don't know. I just haven't really been able to appreciate his art in trailers. I'm maybe harboring on this too much, but I like it. I really like the design that they've gone for here. The OST is great. Bambia! Oh, I love her. She's crazy. Red flag in a woman, but hey, we like a bit of crazy. Okay, that's fine. That's an interesting... I want to go back to that. That's an interesting shot of Robert there. It looks out of place. Maybe it's just me. It looks a little bit out of place. But hey, good nonetheless. I like these scenes. These scenes really show the destruction that they've basically made I would imagine, the span of a minute. So this is great. I would imagine that this is maybe the after effect of those explosions that we see at the start of the first PV with those blue pillars of light. Again, could completely be wrong because those explosions could just be them just teleporting down. So whether those had destructive power or not, I don't know. But still, regardless of what, shows a good feat of their seriousness. This is nice too. Yeah, this is when Basby first appears. Yeah. That Zabimaru looks great. The blue vein. Is that new? I need to double check that. If it is new, there'll be no screenshot on the screen right now. So that will be your answer. But this is great. A great display of the Sturm Ritters. I want to go back again on... I guess the effects with the medallion, again, no issues there. I expected more like thicker lines, but again, the electricity effect looks okay as well. I'm being nitpicky of what like I expected back in 2013 in comparison to now. So this is really interesting choices of effects to go for. That was a good shot of Renji, by the way. Very panel to panel. There's Zabimaru. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I think the blue vein was there on the hand. This, I don't really remember. If this is the case, this will be the first instance where we see blue vein. I like those lines on Yuha too. Like, what we would call the mapper lines. But no, the lines or the cross-stitching, cross-hashing on the face, on the shadows, really adds a layer of depth, which I really like. I think when it comes to Bleach, these up-close shots are going to look gorgeous. I've got absolutely no complaints in the slightest here. Music, animation, everything telling me leading up to this Soul Society breakthrough is just showing more and more menacing than what I experienced from the manga. Like in the manga, it was like, it was fast paced and it was really, really fast paced that you really had to sit there and take time to digest things. And I feel like with the anime, it's really going to accelerate that because you get to spend more time on these appearances, on these destructive feats, because you'll be able to see it visually rather than interpret it. And it's great adding all these little things with the Soul Reapers and whatnot as well to really add that layer of urgency in comparison to why Yama didn't go really, really crazy when Aizen betrayed. Why, you know, Yamamoto never showed urgency within the series whatsoever, even within the Karakura Town War arc. But suddenly he feels a sense of urgency when it comes to the Quincy's. And this is why. This is why Yama is so, like, prepare for war, this is serious. In comparison to his normal, you know, not cold, but calm demeanor that he gave towards Aizen and that war arc of kind of not being stressed about something. He knows the severity. And that's why Yama is such, like, a pivotal moment for this arc, is to see him be stressed for once. So it's great to see that the Quincy's are justifying that to the audience. Whereas in, you know, the manga, we kind of just had to, and of course, going off memory, for the first time I was reading it, we had to kind of just assume that this was a big deal. We didn't know why, but we just had to assume that this was a big deal. So again, really hitting home here. Yeah, fantastic. Even though it was 30 seconds, it is what it is. But the next one is going to be in 8 days, or a week from now, essentially. So get excited for that. And then by that time that PV drops, we're going to have episode one. So we're going to be able to see it in all of its glory. So I can't wait to see what captains they showcase. And I'm probably going to watch this on repeat now. But yes, with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.